2020, the entire UK ended up on lockdown as a result of the global pandemic, COVID-19, more commonly known to you and I as coronavirus. For most of us, this meant staying at home to help protect the NHS and save lives. But for community anchor organisations like DTAS Member Development Trust, it meant something entirely different. It meant activating emergency response mode to help ensure that the most vulnerable people in our communities felt protected, supported and had everything that they needed to help get them through this really scary time. The following is a short compilation of videos from DTAS members talking about what they've been doing in their communities to help with the impact of coronavirus.
As well as our wellbeing cause and our befriending cause, we're offering lots of things online. Online yoga, coffee morning, baby massage, book sessions for example. We have a bike lending service for key workers to keep them getting to and from work safely. GBT are also freshly preparing hot meals for the community. These are going out weekly, along with our food parcels, and these are being delivered by our community drivers. The drivers are also supporting the NHS with transporting patients, samples, and staff between hospitals, and as well as that, keeping our community getting to and from their regular appointments.
What's been amazing during this period of kind of lockdown is the space to provide a bit of clarity and really get back to what our community really needs and what they think is important.
Sonora Development Trust have taken on the role as an anchor organisation and engage with these groups to address any issues they may have and identify areas of concern going forward.
The provision of food, communication, connection with people, and it's quite easy to kind of get drawn in other directions, but it's been great to be able to get back to that.
One positive outcome here in Sonora is the way our communities work together to support each other through this crisis.
In this minibus, delivering food packs and activity packs.
Local community groups and voluntary organisations have all played their part in delivering vital services to the most vulnerable throughout our community.
In partnership with Queen's Cross Housing Association, who we'd worked with a little bit before, and Maryhill Community Central Halls, who we'd not worked with before. We've had to find new kitchen premises and we've been really welcomed in by Flourish House, a local mental health charity. And it's been really heartening to see such a great team effort because none of our organisations could have done this individually.
I'm here at the excellent Flourish House and I'm about to start cooking my cashew nut cauliflower korma for 100 people. And let's look at the cauliflowers. There's so many, it's a cornucopia of cauliflowers. Look at them, they're beautiful.
It's been really heartening to see the speed at which things are happening, with the speed at which Scottish Government have been able to distribute funding, and the speed at which we've been able to react to this really terrible crisis.